This is why in our culture as black people, when the boys turn a certain age, the men come and get him and take him away from the mother because she can emotionally manipulate him. But since we don't live in our culture no more, we say what we want to say, do what we want to say, we tear our men down and then wonder why they don't make good husbands and fathers. Mothers destroy sons. His mother can speak to him in certain ways that destroy him in ways that can never be repaired.
Today's video touches on a very serious topic. Also, a personal issue. And the reason why I named this video Let It Out, But Let It Go, because the main important issue that we must confront and deal with in our own personal lives is healing. Last week, I went to African Holistic Healing Seminar in Chicago. My goal wasn't to give a speech, but to just speak the truth. And not only speak the truth of power, but to inform people that I'm hurting from within. And so when I got up and spoke, I told them I really didn't want to be there, but something told me, because I knew that this was something I needed to get out and let it go and move forward. And so I explained to the audience, I'm hurting deep from within. My own personal issues. Still dealing with the trauma of the death of my niece. But also having to face the reality of my own mother catching COVID. And these things were not only bothering me, but they had me such in a sunken place that I totally excommunicated myself from people for about 6 weeks. And I told them, your brother is hurting. I'm not strong right now. I'm so weak that if something were to happen to my mother, I probably would go crazy. And as I'm speaking, my hands and legs begin to shake. And I started crying. I have no problem showing my emotions when it's needed to be shown. I'm not a crying man every day. But when I need to let go of those emotions and I need to shed a tear for something that is bothering me on a personal level, I will not hesitate into letting those tears flow from my face. It doesn't make me weak as a man at all. And as I was finishing up my speech, I just confessed and said, I want to heal. I'm tired of hurting. I'm tired of dealing with pain. I'm tired of internally suffering. And the entire audience got up and just gave me a group hug. And that felt very good. Because despite the fact I just went up there and just gave a personal testimony, nearly everyone in that audience still viewed me as a brother, and as a friend, and as a comrade, and that they were not going to let me leave that healing session without feeling somewhat relieved, somewhat healed from the things that were bothering me prior to me entering that seminar. Let it out, but let it go. Like me. What we are dealing with in today's society, it kind of breaks my spirit at times. We got brothers fighting sisters saying they don't want nothing to do with black women. We got black women want to use black men, call black men weak, saying black man ain't nothing. We got the children out of control. The children have no guidance and they're led in with a poor direction. And so they're out here want to murder, kill, and harm everybody. And then we have the elders who just giving up on life and blame everything on the younger generation. We got the younger generation blaming everything on the older generation. Yes, it's okay to express your anger, your frustration, but let it go. Black people, we have been in America for over 500 plus years. We have to stop complaining about what happened in the past. We don't ever forget it because it's a part of our history. However, None of us in 2021 ever went through slavery. None of us in 2021, maybe except for a few elders, ever went through Jim Crow discrimination. We haven't gone through nowhere near the amount our ancestors went through, but we're still holding on to it. Let it go. We have the best opportunity here in 2021 and beyond to do something for our people. But yet, we have so much infighting that it hurts. Let's go to Africa. Yes, we were colonized in Africa. Yes, the Arabs and the Europeans and now the Chinese over there subjugating our people. But you want to know how they were able to do so? Thousands and thousands of years of tribalism that we committed against ourselves. We are the reason why fellow Africans all over the world are suffering. But we don't want to call it out. Let it out, but let it go. If you're a brother from Sierra Leone, I don't hate you. If you're a sister from Nigeria, I don't hate you. Let that hate go. Stop thinking because you come from the motherland, you're better than everybody else. Because if you were better than brothers and sisters here in America, the problems that exist in Africa will be gone. I say this out of love, but also out of care and concern. Let it out, but let it go. You will never hear me on this platform say, they African, they ain't got nothing to do with me. That's bullshit. And we can't continue to keep saying that we're indigenous to America, we're American just like everybody else, but America's never given us the same equal treatment that they say they're supposed to give to every single American. See the lies we've been bought, that we bought into? But yet, we look down upon any black person that does not come from America. Because we're still holding on to that hurt. We're still holding on to that pain. We're still relishing in the sojourn of our ancestors. I love and cherish the ancestors. But the ancestors paved the way so that we can take the baton and do it better than what they ever envisioned. Out, but let it go. On a personal level. I no longer feel the guilt of the last relationship I was in, of why that relationship broke up. I'm not holding on to that pain no longer. In fact, I've let it go for the past couple of years because it was destroying me internally. Yes, I would have loved to have a stable family structure with the mother of my child, but it wasn't meant to be. Can I blame her? I could, but I won't. Because at the end of the day, I contributed to the demise of that relationship. And I have to live with the fact that I don't have a great influence over my son as I would love. Even though I still have an influence over him. Because despite the fact we're not together, I have never abandoned my responsibility as a father. Letting out the pain by just going to therapy, but letting it go. Because I know for a fact I can't hold on to disappointment of the ending of that relationship forever. And it's not fair to bring that type of trauma or pain to another woman. I have nothing but the utmost respect for my son's mother. But I let it go. I'm not holding on to what happened in the past. The past is the past. You can never change it. Only thing you can do is learn from what you did wrong in the past and reflect on it and move forward so that you don't make the same mistakes in the future. We have a lot of work to do, family. And it starts from the person within. Black woman, I'm not your enemy. Black man, I'm not your enemy. And we should not be enemies, and we should not be predators to our children. I don't hate my elders. I may disagree with them, but I appreciate and cherish their wisdom because they did it long before I did. The anger, the hurt, the pain, the hate, the frustration, the confusion. Let it go. I don't care about your sexual preference. If you're gay, embrace being gay. If you're straight, embrace being straight. But one thing I will say about this, I will not allow anyone's sexual preference to dictate to me that I should accept something that I know for a fact I don't participate in? Do I hate a person because he's gay? No. And if you're gay, don't hate me because I'm straight. If you're attracted to me, if you're gay, listen, keep that over there. But I'm not homophobic by saying that. Because I enjoy and I embrace and I love and accept who I am as a man. Dealing with all these phobias and these fears. In conclusion, black people, we keep saying white supremacy this, white supremacy that. We're living in fear. Let it out or let it go. No one on the face of this planet can ever stop you from achieving or doing anything you want to do. Just because them crackers did that hundreds of years ago, you think they're going to try to do that to me now? They can attempt, but they will fail. Because I have the spirit of my ancestors, but I carry the essence of the divine goddess of the Most High. I recognize my faults. I acknowledge my failures. But I don't stay fixated on it forever. Because I refuse to allow it to continue to reverberate and continue to have an adverse effect to wealth. I just want to give up on myself. Suicide ain't an option. Neither is homicide. Let it out. What it is you're dealing with, what it is you're feeling. But let it go. Because low self-esteem does us more harm than it will ever do us any good. Continue to work on ourselves. When we recognize our errors in our ways, and we work to change or correct it, and we truly live out our true purpose by exercising our greatness, we're on the course that only the Most High will cherish and appreciate, because God knows how great we truly are. Once we believe that in ourselves, then we will be able to elevate ourselves and our people. That puts us back on top instead of keeping us at the bottom. Let it out that you're tired of being at the bottom, but let it go. Hey, you're stuck at the bottom because you ain't. It's all uphill. Change that mindset and it will heal this. That's all I have to say. Let it out, let it go. Y'all have work to do. We have a purpose on this earth. We mean something to ourselves first, to our families, and to our people. You are valuable. Understand it, believe it, and then live it. Because if you continue to hold on to the past, only thing the past is going to do is lead you to an early grave. And I don't want that for us. And more importantly, you shouldn't want it for yourself. Peace, love. May God bless each and every last one of you. 100.
Brother, let me apologize to you if I hurt you, that we haven't been together. And God is good to bring us back together. All right? I know, man. It hurt me too. Come here, man.